When the assassination occurred, I was asleep. And the next day, my mother had to find a way to explain to me that your father, when you see him, he's going to be in a casket and he won't be able to talk with you. Wow. I mean, for a five-year-old, wow. Literally 7 days before his assassination was my fifth birthday. We couldn't celebrate it that day because my father was leading a march in Memphis, Tennessee, in fact. And he came back home and it was the next day when we celebrated it. And, you know, probably as usual, I was happy and joyous to have Dad at home. But the interesting thing, the emotional roller coaster that occurred for me was when we were at the service here at Ebenezer on April 9th, 1968. Mother said, remember, that he won't be able to talk with you. So right in the middle of that service, they played the speech from February 2nd, the Drum Major Instinct. They played the portion where he talked about his funeral. And suddenly, his voice is booming forth, and I'm looking like, you know, looking for him.
Yes, if you want to say that I was a drum major, say that I was a drum major for justice. Say that I was a drum major for peace. I was a drum major for righteousness.
It's much more difficult being the daughter of Martin Luther King Jr. as an adult than it was as a kid. You know, I had friends, one of the schools I went to was a private school here in Atlanta called the Galloway School. And many of the kids would say, you're the daughter of Martin Luther King Jr. And I'm like, and? because I didn't understand all of that fully. And so the pressure of what all of that may have represented did not hit me. Well, when I went to law school, my first year was very difficult. In fact, I had a cousin who died the Friday before I started law school. And I ended up that semester on probation. I went through the next semester. I was on probation again. Well, for me, that was a lot to swallow because law school for me was like identity, you know. And the thought that I would lose that was devastating. And then, you know, the whole notion of, oh my God, it's gonna be in the papers. I flunk out of law school. And I was already dealing with a lot of anger. And so I went home, got a knife, and trying to figure out how to hurt myself so bad that I would not feel the pain and kind of end life. And I remember my roommate came down and said, what are you doing? And she went back upstairs and called my mom and my aunt and them. And in the midst of her doing that, I heard this voice say, put down the knife. People are gonna miss you. And it was like, whew, something like blew a fresh breath into me. And it's like I came to life at that moment. And you know, my life turned around and I gave my life to Jesus Christ shortly after that and ended up surrendering to this call that was following me into ministry.